I'll introduce now the idea of a bifurcation diagram. Bifurcation diagrams are a way to study differential equations, which may depend on some extra parameter. Now, you've seen such a thing already. When I first introduced the logistic equation, I also discussed the addition of a harvesting term, this minus h. So this differential equation would describe a population x governed by this logistic model, but then I have a minus h, and that minus h represents some constant rate of harvesting applied to the population x. Now, the way to study such a thing and how it depends on the parameter h is essentially to draw a lot of phase lines, and we draw them for various values of the parameter h. So let's look first at the phase line for h equals 0. So it looks like this, and the equilibria are at x equals 0 and x equals 10. And how would I find those? Well, the equilibria are where dx dt is 0. So I take this right-hand side and I set it equal to 0. And I remember that I've set h equal to 0 in order to draw this phase line. So I have 1/10 x times 10 minus x equals 0. And that means x equals 10 and x equals 0. So those are the two equilibria. And then I can test the sine of dx dt above x equals 10 by plugging it into this right-hand side, again with h equals 0. And I find it's negative, so the solution goes down. In between x equals 0 and 10, it's positive, so solution goes up. And below x equals 0, dx dt is negative, so the solution goes down. How about the phase line for h equals 1? So I did h equals 0 right here, so I'll move over one unit and I'll do h equals 1 right here. Now it looks roughly the same, except the two equilibria have moved in a little bit more. And how do I know that? Well, I set h equal to 1 in this equation, and I get 1/10 x times 10 minus x minus 1 equals 0. And I solve for the two x values, which are the equilibria. And those guys are at x equals 5 plus root 10 and x equals 5 minus root 10. So you see that they've moved in a little closer, just inched in toward 5. Okay, how about h equals 2? At h equals 2, something kind of special happens. I only have one equilibrium value, and above and below that equilibrium, dx dt will be negative. I no longer have an area where dx dt is positive, like on the two previous phase lines. And where do I get all this information? Well, I set h equal to 2 in the right-hand side of this equation, and I get 1/10 x times 10 minus x minus 2 equals 0. There's only one root to that equation, that's x equals 5. And I can test that this quantity is negative for x greater than 5 and negative for x less than 5. I can keep drawing more phase lines. For instance, h equals 3. I'll find there are no equilibria, and everywhere dx dt is negative. And again, I find that by simply plugging in h equals 3 into the right-hand side of the equation, setting it equal to 0, and finding there are no real roots x, and hence no equilibria. And in fact, that quantity on the right-hand side is always negative, hence the arrow is pointing down everywhere. Okay, I've taken away all the calculations. What we're left with is the beginning of a bifurcation diagram. I've drawn phase lines for various values of h, and we can see in those phase lines the bifurcation, or the splitting, of equilibria. For instance, at h equals 3, we have no equilibrium values. At h equals 2, one equilibrium appears. Then at h equals 1, we have two equilibria. At h equals 0, I still have two. Now you can imagine drawing in other phase lines in between these, say at h equals 0.5 or h equals 1.5, etc., and we'd sort of get a smooth picture of the way that these equilibrium values split and begin to move apart. So I can draw that smooth line in. It's a parabola, in fact. And how do I know it's a parabola? Well, it's exactly described by this equation, 1/10 x times 10 minus x minus h equals 0. And that is a parabola in the x, h plane. So if I draw on these axes here, make this the h-axis, and these are the various values of h that I've chosen, h equals 0, h equals 1, h equals 2, etc. And this is the x-axis represented by the vertical position on the phase line. Then that's the parabola. It's a sideways parabola given by this equation. So that pretty much completes our picture. We now have a bifurcation diagram, which is the bifurcation diagram for the example equation that I gave, and that is the logistic equation with some harvesting parameter h. And we can use that bifurcation diagram to study how this logistic model depends on the harvesting h. And if you remember, that was our original goal, to study how an ODE depends on a parameter. And in fact, we can answer some questions about harvesting rates. Now let's suppose, just to make things a little more real, that X represents a population of fish, let's say in some lake. So that means, without any harvesting, that the population of fish is governed by a logistic model, given here. Now, H would represent some fishing rate, some rate at which I catch fish and remove them from the lake. Now, my question for you would be, what is the maximum sustainable fishing rate? At what rate do I know that I can fish without killing off the fish population entirely?